Look at your watch for a moment. The seconds are passing, one after another. Steady, predictable, comforting. We live our entire lives trusting this rhythm. We assume that a second is a second everywhere in the universe. We assume that the passing of time is simple, clean, universal. But deep beneath the Earth's surface, far away from sunlight and cosmic noise, scientists are performing one of the most delicate experiments in modern physics. An experiment so precise, so unbelievably sensitive, that even the tiniest imperfections in measuring time could change our understanding of the universe itself. And at the heart of this mystery lies one of the simplest particles known to science, the neutron. To understand what makes this particle so strange, imagine this. Inside an atom, a neutron is perfectly stable. It can survive for billions of years without changing. But the moment you pull it out of the nucleus and leave it alone, it begins to die. Quietly, predictably, and with almost clock-like precision, it decays into a proton, an electron, and an antineutrino. This transformation is called beta decay, and it happens with a regularity that should, in theory, be one of the most well-understood processes in physics. But it isn't. For decades, physicists have tried to measure exactly how long a free neutron survives before it decays. You might think this would be simple. After all, we're talking about timing a process that happens thousands of times per second in every reactor in the world. But the more precisely scientists measure it, the stranger the result becomes. The expected lifetime of a neutron, give or take a tiny fraction, is around 880 seconds, about 14 minutes and 40 seconds. Except, two different experiments give two different answers. The first experiment is called the bottle method. In this method, scientists trap a collection of neutrons inside a specialized container, often using magnetic fields or material walls that reflect neutrons. They wait, they count how many remain, and from that, they calculate how many have decayed. This method consistently produces a lifetime of about 879.4 seconds. The second experiment is called the beam method. Here, neutrons are fired through a beamline, and as they decay, they produce protons. The experiment counts the number of protons appearing in the beam, and from that, it infers how many neutrons have decayed. This method consistently gives a longer result, about 887.7 seconds. Two extraordinarily precise methods, two extremely consistent answers, but separated by nearly 8 seconds. Now, 8 seconds may not sound like much, but in particle physics, where precision is everything, an 8-second gap is enormous. So enormous that it represents a 4-sigma discrepancy, far beyond the margin of experimental error, too large to ignore, too large to explain away, and far too large to accept without questioning whether we truly understand everything that is happening inside the neutron. This is the neutron lifetime puzzle. To solve it, scientists need experiments that are unimaginably clean, experiments where the only thing being measured is the decay of the neutron itself, without interference from the chaos of the outside world. And this is where deep underground laboratories come into the story. On the surface of the Earth, detectors are constantly bombarded by cosmic rays, high-energy particles streaming through the atmosphere, blasting through equipment, and creating showers of secondary radiation. These particles interfere with sensitive detectors, create false signals, and mask the tiny signatures scientists are trying to isolate. Now imagine trying to count the decay of a single neutron while millions of cosmic particles are flying through your laboratory every minute. It's like trying to listen for a single drop of water falling inside a hurricane. This is why the world's most delicate physics experiments are moved deep underground. Laboratories such as the Gran Sasso National Laboratory in Italy, or the Boulby Underground Laboratory in the United Kingdom, are built beneath kilometers of solid rock. And that rock acts as an enormous shield, absorbing almost all incoming cosmic rays and creating a quiet sanctuary, a place where scientists can listen to the faintest whispers of the universe. These underground laboratories are not just caves with equipment. They are some of the most advanced scientific facilities on Earth. Here, detectors can operate in an environment almost completely free from background noise. And although these laboratories are not currently where the neutron lifetime is measured, they are exactly the kind of controlled environments that future experiments may require to finally resolve the discrepancy between the bottle and beam methods. So what could be causing the 8-second difference? There are three major possibilities. The first possibility is deceptively simple. One of the experiments might contain a tiny, systematic error that no one has yet managed to detect. For example, in the bottle method, some neutrons might be lost because they interact with the walls of the container rather than decaying naturally. Or, in the beam method, the proton detectors might not capture every decay event with perfect efficiency. Even a difference of a fraction of a percent could shift the result by several seconds. But after years of refinement, no one has identified a definitive flaw. The second possibility is far more exotic, and it has stirred enormous excitement. The neutron might have a hidden decay channel. In other words, a small percentage of neutrons, perhaps 1%, might decay into something entirely invisible, something that standard detectors cannot see, something that does not produce a proton, perhaps a particle of dark matter. This is not a fringe idea. It is a serious scientific proposal published in peer-reviewed research. If neutrons can decay into a dark matter particle, the bottle method would detect the disappearance of neutrons, but the beam method, counting only protons, would miss those invisible decays and therefore measure a longer lifetime. An 8-second gap is exactly what you would expect if 1% of neutron decays were slipping into the dark, literally. The third possibility is that the neutron decay process might involve physics that the standard model, the great theoretical framework of particle physics, does not yet include. Something about the weak nuclear force might be slightly more complex than we currently believe. Perhaps there are symmetry violations, or rare transitions, or interactions involving sterile neutrinos, particles that barely interact with anything at all. In this scenario, the neutron lifetime puzzle isn't a problem. It's a clue. A clue that the fundamental laws of nature may be hiding something in plain sight. Right now, a new generation of experiments is being built to settle the puzzle once and for all. These experiments use ultra-cold neutrons stored in magnetic traps, proton detection systems at unprecedented precision, and cryogenic technologies that can eliminate even the smallest sources of error. Some proposals even combine both the bottle and beam methods in the same apparatus, something that has never been done before. Many of these new designs will likely be placed underground, where the Earth itself can shield the detectors from cosmic noise. In a sense, the planet becomes part of the apparatus, an essential, natural component of the experiment. And when the mystery is finally solved, one of three things will happen. Either scientists will confirm that neutrons do indeed live for exactly about 880 seconds, and the discrepancy was due to subtle experimental effects. Or they will discover a new decay channel, possibly revealing the connection between ordinary matter and dark matter. Or, most spectacularly, the solution will point toward new physics, an adjustment in our understanding of the weak force, or even a hint that something deeper is happening inside the fabric of the universe itself. So, look at your watch again. The seconds continue to tick away, each one just like the one before it. But deep below your feet, in laboratories carved out of ancient rock, scientists are listening to a different kind of clock, the silent countdown of the neutron. A clock that could rewrite our understanding of matter, energy, and the universe. And the mystery is still unsolved. The clock is still ticking. And somewhere, in the decay of a single neutron, the answer is waiting. If you found this mystery fascinating, hit the like button and subscribe. Veil Origins. Impossible Truths.